But how our intelligence, or more precisely how our IQ levels, is determined? Maybe many of you assume that intelligence are mostly derived from hereditary, where it is passed down from our parents to us through genetic assortment. But I do believe that intelligence comes from environmental factors, just like how genetic factors can influence intelligence. Environment factors do play a fair share in influencing a person's intelligence. These factors can be further studied through the effects of early nutrition provided to a child and also the early intervention of schooling that a child received. Today, I'd like to convince you guys that environmental factors do play a major role in determining a person's intelligence, just like how genetic factors can cause a strong impact on a person's intelligence. Actually, the environmental factors that will be discussed today can be enhanced progressively to gradually increase a person's intelligence. One of the first environmental factors that is controlling our intelligence is the effect of nutrition during the early life of a child. If an infant or a young children is suffering from major malnutrition during their slow growing phase of life for further and distinct development of their whole body and physiological function, it can cause a severe limitation to the neurological development of their brain and also can cause a long-term effect on their cognitive development as well. This can disrupt a child's intelligence as their neuron cells are unable to communicate well with one another to induce a signal that can enhance their critical thinking skills and also their IQ level. As a consequence, a child's basic study skills, such as reading, writing, memorizing, calculating, all of this will disrupt and collapse due to the inadequate amount of nutrition resources. The most convincing study on the adverse effect of malnutrition to intelligence comes from a study conducted on identical twins. This occurs when there is a reduced blood supply flow from the placenta to one of the twins, causing that particular twins to have a reduced supply of nutrients that can cause retarded growth and as well as abnormal small size at birth. This first kind of study was conducted by Churchill in 1965. He is a British Army officer, a writer, and also a professor. Through his study that he conducted on the 20 identical twins, he found out that the heavier twins have a slightly higher IQ, mean IQ levels than the lighter twins. He concluded the experiment by saying that this is due to the heavier twins have a larger head circumference than the lighter twins that resulted in a significantly higher IQ level. Next, the other environmental factors that is affecting our intelligence is the effect of early intervention of schooling provided to a child. A number of studies have been carried out show that a child studying in school and their intelligence level do influence each other. Prolonged schooling in a child can result in that child having a higher intelligence because they are more prone to gain a higher IQ level when he or she stays in school for a longer period of time. The studies conducted by Sorrell Cahen and also Philip Cohen in 1992 found out that children in higher grades tend to have a higher IQ in comparison with their peer classmates who are younger that is studying in lower grades. But the most convincing analytical results showed that higher grade students do tend to have a higher IQ levels than their peer classmates who are in lower grades. I would like you guys to understand that environmental factors such as the nutrition of infants in the early life and also the early intervention of schooling is as equally important as genetic factors in determining a person's intelligence. I do hope that you guys can begin to understand that Environmental factors is really as important as genetic factors in influencing a person's intelligence. As you can see, intelligence level can really be increased gradually by emphasizing the importance of environmental factors. This shows that environmental factors is really as important as genetic factors, because it shows that the intelligence of a person's performance has been rising each year. I'll end with a quote by Martin Luther King Jr., who is an American Baptist minister and an activist, who said that the function of education is to teach one to think intensively and to think